Also going on, we're going to review the major scale. Let me zoom in a little bit. The major scale, again, written on the staff, or we're going to look at it on a piano keyboard here in a second, same thing, but let's look at the notes first. A whole step, W for whole step, is from key to key with no key in between on the piano. So this is a whole step, then another whole step, and then a half step. A half step is key to key on the piano with no key in between. This one has one key in between. I might have misspoke myself there. Whole step, one key in between. Half step, no keys in between. Okay, so it's just key to key, note to note, nothing in between. So the formula for a major scale, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, is whole, whole, half, whole, 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 half. Say it with me. Whole, whole, half, whole, 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 half. One more time. Whole, whole, half, whole, 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 half. Okay, got it? Good. Let's move on to the keyboard and look at it on the keyboard. Here's some piano keys. Let me actually zoom in on this as well. Now, going with that formula that we just learned, if we start on a C and we go whole, we're going to go from here, we're going to skip over this black note and end up here on D. Whole, skipping over one note in between. Whole, skipping over one note in between. Half, no note in between. Whole, skipping a note. Whole, skipping a note. Whole, skipping a note. Half, no key in between. Now, you notice that there are no black notes between E and F, okay, and B and C. That's because this is called a natural half step. There's no black notes in between, and that's where those halves end up automatically because we started on C, in the key of C, which has no sharps and no flats. But let's look at this. What if we started on D? What's going to happen? Well, let's find out. Whole, skipping over the black note. Let me actually skip the black note here. Let's start up in here. Because you have to keep your attention right through the black keys. You can't look here. You have to look through where the black keys are included. So D to E is a whole step. But look what happens. Whole, whole. We end up on a black note. That's our first key signature. That's actually F sharp. Okay. So it's whole, whole, half, that's G, right? Let me put it here, keep it here. And then whole, 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 we end up on another black key, that's C sharp, half, okay? So if you can see, we ended up on this sharp note, and we ended up on this black sharp note, okay? So in the key of D major, there are two sharps, and that's called a key signature, all right? And I'm going to give you a formula of how to figure these out very quickly and easily without even doing any of what I just showed you. But I want you to understand it's a template that moves across this whole thing from here to here. It's a template that moves across the piano, all right, or across any musical instrument. It's easy to visualize on a piano keyboard. That's why I'm using it. That's one of the reasons they call the piano the master instrument. If you truly want to learn music theory and you truly want to learn how to compose and understand music, one of the easiest instruments to learn it on is the piano because it's laid out right here in front of you, right? It's very visual. It's not as easy to visualize on a guitar or on a flute or a saxophone or a trumpet, okay? All right, so D has two sharps, F and C sharp. So the name of the key is the same thing as the name of the scale, in this case, D major. And the key signature are which black notes we're playing, basically, okay? How many sharps and how many flats?